Have you ever cut open a tomato and found seeds sprouting inside? Did you wonder what caused it? What did you do with it? Did you eat it? I planted mine.
Hello, this is Stephen from Short Season Garden, and I offer tips and tricks for gardening in any climate, but especially for short seasons like here in Zone 3 in Eastern Canada. So subscribe to my channel, give my video a thumbs up and a comment, or you can check me out on social media on Instagram or Facebook at Short Season Garden.
So if you've ever tried to save tomato seeds to plant, you know that they have a protective gel coating that must be removed before they can germinate. So imagine my surprise when my friend Donnie showed me a sliced tomato with sprouted seeds inside. It turns out that this phenomenon known as vivipary, or live birth, is not as rare as it might seem. If tomatoes are stored long term, the hormone that causes the seed to remain dormant can eventually run out, allowing the seeds to actually sprout inside the live, moist tomato. You see, my friend Donnie has a high tunnel, which is a great season extender for tomatoes. Sometimes when harvest is abundant and life gets crazy, we just can't get everything used, and that's what happened this year. Thanks to a very unseasonably mild fall and Donnie's ingenious self-wicking planters, the tomatoes were able to survive into November without any supplemental heat. Although some rotted and became unusable, the cool autumn weather allowed many to ripen very slowly. However, time was running out on the seed dormancy, and these ones started to sprout. Online opinion is divided on the edibility of the sprouted tomato slices. If you've watched some of my other videos, you know that I've tried some unique experiments, so I thought it was time for another one. I buried the sprouted seeds, tomato and all, in potting soil. Then I watered them from the bottom. In about 3 days, some of the sprouts started to emerge from the soil. I didn't like the moldy appearance that I attributed to the fruit starting to decompose, so I applied a generous cover of vermiculite. Over the next few days, a half dozen seedlings began to emerge. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with tomato plants indoors in Zone 3B, 4A in December and January, but for now they are thriving under my LED grow lights. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and a comment. Subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you in the next video.